Welcome to CenterFest 2020, virtual arts festival presented by the Durham Arts Council. CenterFest 2020 Virtual Arts Festival is sponsored by SciMed Solutions, NetFriends, Measurement Incorporated, Rivers, Adam Dickinson Realty Group, Durham Coca-Cola Bottling Company, The Herald Sun, Durham Magazine, WUNC North Carolina Public Radio, and Burge Records. Thank you to our sponsors, and thank you for watching. Enjoy the show!
Virtual CenterFest viewers, I am Dr. Connie Gomez-Joynes, President of the Durham Arts Council Board of Trustees. We welcome you to Virtual CenterFest 2020. This is our 46th year presenting CenterFest Arts Festival for the community, and it is the first time that we are doing it virtually. Due to COVID-19 pandemic, we're all safe at home, but we can still enjoy a great lineup of visual artists, performing artists, CenterFest memories over the years, and special guests in the comfort of our own living rooms.
Hi, I'm Baron Timas, Vice President and President-elect of the Durham Arts Council Board. Welcome to CenterFest. Tonight, in three 45-minute episodes from 6 p.m. to 9 p.m., you can enjoy amazing local music groups, energetic dance groups, and 57 talented visual artists, both here in the broadcast and on the website at centerfest2020.org. Featured performers include Durham's own Lenora Zenzele-Helm and Pierce Freelon, fan favorite Ricardo Diguez and the Tropic Orchestra, and yours truly playing some jazz with the Baron Timas Quartet. And keep an eye out for visits from special guests.
Thanks, Baron and Connie, and welcome everyone to CenterFest 2020. Virtually. We're so glad that you've tuned in to watch from the comfort of your home. And we're so proud to be presenting this. The Durham Arts Council has brought CenterFest to the community for 46 years. And we're also thankful to our presenting sponsors, Durham's own NetFriends and SciMed Solutions. And also we'd like to thank the sponsors of our Visual Artist Awards, Durham Coca-Cola, and the Herald Sun. And also, thank you to performance sponsor Merge Records and to our media sponsors, WUNC and Durham Magazine, and to our design sponsor, Rivers. So tune in throughout all three episodes this evening and enjoy. And we hope you'll check out the website, centerfest2020.org. Be sure to check out the visual artists there and purchase some art. We're even offering curbside pickup of your art purchases from local artists. So enjoy CenterFest. And now back to Connie.
And now we hope that you will sit back and enjoy the CenterFest broadcast.
Hi, folks. Welcome and thanks for tuning in to Virtual CenterFest 2020. I'm Mark Lee, radio producer and longtime CenterFest volunteer. I'd like to take you on a journey down memory lane to visit some great moments in CenterFest history over its 46 years. In the early 1990s, I became involved with the Durham Arts Council, and I've thoroughly enjoyed working with this great organization and one of its signature events, CenterFest. I've really enjoyed being a major voice of this festival as performance stage MC. From blues, jazz, and rock, to classical music, ballet, tap, Indian dance, and more, I've had the pleasure of introducing hundreds of performing acts to the CenterFest audience in downtown Durham each year. CenterFest launched originally as the Triangle Festival of Crafts by Allied Arts the original Durham Arts Council, and was co-chaired by Pepper Fluke and Virginia Osborne. The small emerging festival took place at the Allied Arts Building on Proctor Street. From 1972 to 1976, the Triangle Festival of Crafts developed as a partnership of Allied Arts and the Craft House of Durham, with locations at the National Guard Armory and the Downtown Armory. From the beginning, the event sought to build an audience for crafts in a state renowned for its traditional craft artisans. In 1977, the festival became the Bull City Street Art Celebration and moved outdoors to Main Street and Five Points, and remained an outdoor event going forward. In 1984, the Durham Arts Council expanded the festival to 2 days and renamed it CenterFest, and partnered with Durham Parks and Recreation, focusing on the need to revive the struggling downtown district. The festival included a breakdancing competition at the old Durham Bulls Athletic Park. The new energy helped attract 100,000 attendees and set the stage for launching the capital campaigns to renovate the Durham Arts Council and Carolina Theater buildings. In 1988, CenterFest featured the opening celebration of the newly renovated Durham Arts Council building. CenterFest in the 1990s continued with top performing talent and visual artists from across the U.S., plus poster designs by such renowned artists as Bob Rankin and Susan Shepherd. Visitors loved making art for the Hopes and Wishes Maypole and enjoyed a swing salsa dance kickoff event. So many great memories, whether it was us scrambling to dodge for cover when a storm brewed up, or walking around the entire CenterFest site and seeing so many friends and acquaintances. And of course, some great performances. Jazz greats from our community, like Eve Cornelius, Nina Freelon, and Stanley Barrett. And of course, the late, great Bobby Chuck Davis. And of course, there were hard decisions, like the decision in 2001 to hold CenterFest a week and a half after that tragic 9/11 date. But it is what the community needed, as it helped this area heal and cope with this horrible tragedy in our world history. And of course, I remember when a local artist helped us out when some equipment was stolen at CenterFest. Bobby Hinton, an area blues musician, kindly loaned his equipment to help us because, as the old saying goes, the show must go on. Other great performers over the years have included B.O. Ritmo, Cephas and Wiggins, Mel Melton, Cool John Ferguson, John D. Holman, Carnivalito, the Durham Community Concert Band, the Bouncing Bulldogs, the Pinkerton Raid, Emily Mussolini, Risa Palmer, the Acting Kids from Young People's Performing Company. So many parts of our very diverse community have been represented at CenterFest. As downtown Durham has experienced dramatic revitalization in the last two decades, CenterFest continues to draw huge and happy crowds to enjoy a showcase of visual and performing arts, local organizations, great food, and the vibrant, evolving community we all love. In recent years, CenterFest has ranked in the top 100 fine art and design shows in the United States, and continues to be the longest running outdoor arts festival in North Carolina. I can't wait till we can get this pandemic under control and we can be out again safely watching these performances. But in the meantime, let's catch up with our rich talent here in this virtual CenterFest broadcast. Hope to see you back out in public soon, and hopefully at CenterFest next year.
We'll be right back. The Durham Arts Council is supportive, collaborative, community-oriented, innovative, fun for all ages and abilities. Help the Durham Arts Council create a vibrant community through the arts. Please donate today.
I think the reason why people are drawn to unique custom-made items is because we want something very special and unique that reminds us of experiences or people that we've had. And the idea behind my work is to have everyday items that are especially meaningful to us. Coffee mugs that tell a story related to your family, or plates that you eat of every day that are imbued with things about your favorite grandparent. So I use my clients' materials and we press them into clay and tell their stories through those materials. When people come to me, they hope that this object will beautify their life, bring meaning to their life. That means for me that I'm leaving an impact on the world and society and making people a little bit happier and a little bit more grounded in their own story.
Precious Ones, and it's just a brief reminder of remembering to see all the things around us that are really, really, really precious, including people, including ourselves. So here we go, the Precious Ones.
Mishandled by someone. The youngest tree's growth is easily stunted if burned by the sun. Cherish the precious ones. We don't cherish the precious ones. Thank you. softest silk, the darkest hour, the sweetest milk, the highest power. What we take for granted are the most enchanting things on this earth. Blind to their worth, cherish the precious ones. We should cherish the precious ones. We must cherish the precious ones. Cherish the precious ones.
Thank you. Hi, I'm Steve Shull, the mayor of Durham, and I am here with you at Virtual CenterFest 2020, the 46th annual Fine Arts Festival produced by the Durham Arts Council. I'm enjoying the music, as I know you are. I'm enjoying the artists who are here with us at Virtual CenterFest. Durham Arts Council has supported so many artists over the years and arts education for so many young people and people like me, as old as I am. And it's also done every year, it's done CenterFest, which is a wonderful festival. I love to wander the booths. I love to see the civic organizations out and to see all of you out there. And it's great to be here again today in this new format. And I applaud the Durham Arts Council for its ingenuity in keeping Durham's wonderful signature arts festival going in this new way. Times are tough in Durham and throughout the country. There's no question about it. But we are getting back on the bull in Durham, and Virtual CenterFest is one of the ways in which we're doing that. We're gonna get through this together, and I'm gonna keep enjoying CenterFest, and I hope you are too through the rest of the festival today.
Pasa. the Durham Arts Council Arts Recovery Fund is helping artists, arts organizations, and arts businesses impacted by the COVID-19 pandemic. If you can, please donate to support arts recovery in Durham. Give so the arts can live.
Let's go. My style can't be duplicated or recycled. This chick is a sick individual. Sick take! Fire two! Woo! Let me switch up the game.
Thank you. where you know you will be welcome.
My name is Lauren Desair, and I am a 2D mixed media artist located in Pittsboro, North Carolina. My work is created using paper, acrylic paint, graphite, and ink. I use imagery of nature and animals to create stories addressing societal and environmental issues. In my work, I explore how these issues intersect with the human narrative and my own experiences as a woman and as an artist in the modern world. My technique consists of many processes and layers, and I believe that this helps the viewer to look closely at the work, gradually unveiling hidden nuances and details, both in technique and in the stories that I create. Our world is rapidly changing, and it is only through real self-reflection, discovery, and a sense of open-mindedness that we will be able to come together to save it.
Day, girl, what up? Right now, we can go anywhere you wanna. Yeah. Roller skating rink to the movies, chilling at the house. Maybe later on, we could go get a banana float. Yeah, cause that's really tasty. We can be lazy, stop and smell the daisies. Do what you want, me and you in the car. Go play in the arcade or shop at the mall. Hope you're ready for a wonderful day. Sunny outside, hope you're ready to play. When your mama asks you how your day went, you gon' tell her daddy be your favorite.
Sun is going down now, get into your jammies. Yeah. Bedtime concert, performing at your Grammys. Close your eyes and now it's sleepy time. Tomorrow we go, press rewind. Daddy da da day, 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 daddy da 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 day, daddy da da day, hey daddy da da day.
Daddy-daughter day, it's a daddy-daughter day. And the sun is so much brighter when it's smiling on your face. Homies call to hit the bar, tell them try another day. Rather be right where you are, you can pick your favorite place. We can hit the museum, life is science, you see them. Animals and zoos even recognize the beauty. And your smile as it radiates, you hide and we play and chase. Even if we doing nothing, it's time we can never waste. Tell mommy we go and play, just me and you on a date. Hope nobody told mommy for dinner we order cake. With ice cream and chocolate, Lion King, we watched it. At least 100 times, just so you can hear him say Hakuna Matata, this what we do with our daughters. And a salute to the fathers, doing it all to provide a model of who you should follow. Promise to guide you on where to go. It's a daddy-daughter day, bruh, fatherhood is dope.
Down. da 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 da.
Hi, everyone. This is State Representative Zach Hawkins, and I am so excited to serve the people of the city and county of Durham and House District 31. And so I am glad to welcome you to the virtual CenterFest 2020, the 46th annual Fine Arts Festival presented by the Durham Arts Council. The value of the arts is something that can't be denied. In 1968, in my home, in a small town in eastern North Carolina, the first thing that my grandmother bought before she bought furniture was a piano. She taught all of us, including my mom, her brothers and sisters, and my brothers and sisters, how to play the piano. It shaped my life, and it continues to shape the lives of people around the nation and around the state of North Carolina. The arts are absolutely essential. And so even though we have to move to a virtual environment, we want to make sure that we continue to highlight the arts.
Yeah.
The Durham Arts Council is supportive, collaborative, community-oriented, innovative, fun for all ages and abilities. Help the Durham Arts Council create a vibrant community through the arts. Please donate today.
the CenterFest 2020 Virtual Arts Festival presented by the Durham Arts Council. CenterFest 2020 Virtual Arts Festival is sponsored by SciMed Solutions, NetFriends, Measurement Incorporated, Rivers, Adam Dickinson Realty Group, Durham Coca-Cola Bottling Company, The Herald Sun, Durham Magazine, WUNC North Carolina Public Radio, and Burge Records. Thank you to our sponsors, and thank you for watching. Enjoy the show.
Hey, I'm Senator Mike Woodard, representing North Carolina Senate District 22, and I'm also a proud former board president of the Durham Arts Council. Because of the COVID-19 pandemic, the in-person downtown festival can't take place this year, but I'm so glad you're joining me to experience virtual CenterFest 2020 from the comfort of your home. I've been a big supporter of the Durham Arts Council and of CenterFest for many years, all the way back to 1984. I was thinking about one of my favorite CenterFest memories, and it was in 1992, when a young jazz singer had just released her first album, and people were excited to see her. That was Durham's own Nina Freelon, and she turned in an amazing performance on Saturday afternoon with her great friend, guitarist Scott Sawyer. And then on that Sunday, we had the jazz legend Charlie Byrd perform. But it rained that afternoon, so I had to run with Charlie Byrd through the streets of Durham. I had an umbrella in one hand and Mr. Byrd's guitar case in the other. We dashed into the PSI Theater, where over 300 people, well above fire marshal regulations, got to witness an incredible intimate concert and one of my favorite memories of any artistic performance. For 46 years, the Durham Arts Council has proudly presented the CenterFest Arts Festival on the third weekend in September, attracting up to 35,000 people to downtown Durham for a lively weekend of visual arts, performing arts, a showcase of our community organizations, plus food and family fun for all ages. CenterFest is nationally ranked in the top 100 fine arts festivals in the United States and is North Carolina's longest running juried outdoor arts festival. As you know, the arts are central to Durham's identity as a diverse, creative, and vibrant community. CenterFest Arts Festival showcases amazing and diverse talents from near and far. Singers, dance troupes, bands, and jugglers, to painters, woodworkers, potters, and jewelers. Plus, families are entertained at the Creative Kids Zone, and pets enjoy cooling off at the Pet Oasis. And of course, the food. I always enjoy grabbing a bite or two to eat at our on-site food vendors or at Durham's great local downtown restaurants. From its early days in the 70s, CenterFest has always had the goal of showcasing arts and attracting residents and visitors to the redeveloping and re-emerging downtown Durham. What a better way to invite and encourage folks to come and see all that is new and happening in our downtown each year. From 1984 to 2006, CenterFest radiated out from 5 points across Morris Street and down Main and Chapel Hill Streets past the old CCB Plaza. From 2008 to 2010, CenterFest relocated to the other adjacent downtown sites near Brightleaf and Durham Central Park, while the central downtown streets and plazas were being resurfaced. then CenterFest reemerged in the heart of the revitalized downtown Durham in 2012, where it has been growing and thriving ever since. I hope our entire community and the world can return to in-person celebrations soon. And I am counting on seeing you live and in person at CenterFest next year. Thanks for tuning in.
Hi, everybody. My name is Charlie Reese. I'm a member of the Durham City Council, and I'm also on the Board of Trustees for the Durham Arts Council. And I'm proud to welcome you to Virtual CenterFest 2020. This is our 46th annual arts festival here in the city of Durham, celebrating everything about Durham's art community. Our community of artists is one of the things that makes Durham so special, and I'm very, very happy and proud to share that with you today. So enjoy your visit to our virtual CenterFest, and have a great day.
Durham Arts Council is supportive, collaborative, community-oriented, innovative, fun for all ages and abilities. Help the Durham Arts Council create a vibrant community through the arts. Please donate today.
My name is Karen Newberth. I paint nature-inspired paintings in acrylic using a palette knife. I start each of my paintings with an abstract underpainting. Although I'll add many more layers, bits of this underpainting will always be visible when the painting is completed. I paint with a very limited palette of colors, mixing all of my colors from the primaries. By using a palette knife instead of a brush, I'm able to create unique textures. Whether I'm painting an abstract floral or a wooded landscape, you can be sure that I put my heart and soul into every painting.
Welcome to CenterFest 2020. I'm Jackie Shelton Green, the North Carolina Poet Laureate. I'm also a teacher and a cultural and community activist. Since I was appointed as the North Carolina Poet Laureate in 2018, I've been traveling across the state of North Carolina, listening to the amazing stories across our state. I am deeply fascinated by how communities are engaging the power of language, how families are telling their stories inside of those communities. I believe that when we share our stories and tell our stories to each other, over and over again, we find ourselves inside of each other's stories. What are your stories? Who are you sharing your stories with? How are you celebrating your stories inside of your families and your communities? Please join me today as we celebrate the valuable importance and role of the arts in all of our lives. Open a doorway today and show the world your creativity. Now more than ever, we need to uplift and celebrate all of our stories.
This is Senator Natalie Murdoch, the new senator representing you right here in Durham, and so happy to be here with all of you virtually. This is typically that time of the year where we are deep in festival season. I'm typically right there with you at CenterFest, getting folks registered to vote. And even though we have a virtual celebration this year, we still have to continue to support and do everything we can do for the arts. I know I personally will be looking forward to virtually purchasing some pieces today, and just can't stress enough the importance of supporting the art community. And just know that I'm fighting to do all that we possibly can to provide additional support for the arts, because they are just such a critical, critical component to our community as well as our economy right here in Durham. Also, cannot let this opportunity go by without reminding all of you how important it is to fill out your census. It is not too late. You can do it online. It takes less than 10 minutes. We will quite literally leave over $1 billion, that is billion with a B, dollars on the table at the state level if we fail to fill out that census. Voting is also around the corner. Starting September 5th, if you requested your absentee ballot, you will start getting that in the mail. So it is not too late to request your absentee ballot. Fill that out, turn it in as soon as you receive it. And you also can safely vote during early voting. So figure out a way to vote, get involved, be active. Again, we want to champion the arts. We want to expand Medicaid. We want to fund our schools, our public schools. None of that can happen if we do not make some serious changes in November. So Kent, thank you all enough for being here with us today. And thank you, CenterFest. And let's have a great celebration today.
You're tighter than two lovers in the backseat of a car, tighter than the pockets of a hustler in a bar, tighter than a drunk walking on his knees. This place where they call it,
Durham Arts Council is supportive, collaborative, community oriented, innovative, fun for all ages and abilities. Help the Durham Arts Council create a vibrant community through the arts. Please donate today.
Hi, I'm Wendy Allen of Misfit & Company. I specialize in hand-felted merino wool hats and other accessories. This is a time-lapse video demonstration of some of my techniques, and today I will be making this hat for a customer from this drawing. Let's see how it turns out. Thanks for watching.
repetí comprobar. Y comprobar, ayer te bebé vino tinto, y está burbu y colorado. Ayer que bebé vino tinto,
chiquillo,
y está gordo y colorado.
Chiquillo.
Thank you.
Hello, everybody. I'm Wendy Jacobs, chair of the Durham County Board of Commissioners, and I'm so excited to welcome you to the 46th anniversary of CenterFest, one of the most exciting times of the year in our community. And I always look forward to CenterFest, and I wish I could be walking down the street with you today and stopping at all of the booths and enjoying the music and great food. But we're so lucky that we get to experience CenterFest virtually and still be able to support our artists and enjoy our great musicians and bring some of the heart and soul of the arts that are so important for all of our lives into our homes today. So I want to encourage everybody to just enjoy CenterFest. Thank you.
canoa rancha que tú me mandaste traer. Ya viene rompiendo el agua solo por venir a ver. En esta canoa rancha que tú me mandaste traer. Ya viene rompiendo el agua solo por venir a ver.
Virtual CenterFest viewers, I am Dr. Connie Gomez-Joins, President of the Durham Arts Council Board of Trustees. I hope you are enjoying Virtual CenterFest 2020.
And greetings, everyone. I'm Sherry DeVries, the Executive Director of the Durham Arts Council, and thank you for tuning in to watch Virtual CenterFest 2020. The Durham Arts Council has presented the festival for 46 years. This is the first time that we're doing it virtually from the safety of our homes. I'd like to thank our presenting sponsors, Durham's own NetFriends and SciMed Solutions. And also thank you to this year's sponsors of the Merit Awards for our visual artists, Durham Coca-Cola, and the Herald Sun. We hope while you're staying at home that you're stocking up on plenty of Coca-Cola products and enjoying them from your own living rooms. The Herald Sun is driven by a desire to make communities and businesses stronger and more successful. Follow their award-winning journalism in both print and digital platforms.
It is our honor and pleasure to present the CenterFest 2020 Visual Art Merit Awards, including Best in Show, First Place, Second Place, Third Place, and Top Durham Artist Award.
These artists were chosen by a panel of visual arts professionals, including Anna Lee from ArtSpace in Raleigh, Sarah Hill from Hamilton Hill Jewelry in Durham, and Tamar Harris Warren from Arts Access in Raleigh. We want to thank the judges for their time and expertise in reviewing all of the 57 artists that are participating and making their award selections. Thank you. And now, Connie, to present the awards.
The winner of the Top Durham Artist Award is Wendy Allen, and Wendy works with fiber. Wendy works exclusively in wet felted merino wool to create beautiful and sculptural hats, scarves, mittens, and other accessories that are sure to keep you warm in the winter months. She receives an award ribbon, a $300 cash award, plus a free artist booth at CenterFest next year. Our third place award winner is Dale Watterson, and Dale works with wood. Dale is from High Point, North Carolina. His beautiful hand-turned segmented wood bowls are made from environmentally responsibly harvested wood in natural color, custom dye in acrylic resins. The bowls are both solid and open segment construction. Dale will receive an award ribbon and cash award of $400. Congratulations, Dale. Our second place award winner is Jason Stoddart, and he is a photographer. Jason is from Cookeville, Tennessee. In his photography, Jason documents America's leftovers, finding forgotten objects that tell a story. Jason uses modern techniques to achieve the traditional sepia tone, hand-tinted style using museum archival materials in his studio. Jason will receive a second place award and cash award of $500. Congratulations, Jason. Our first place award winner is Xiang Ting Yun. She makes jewelry. Xiang Ting is from Raleigh, North Carolina. Her exquisite jewelry is the marriage of geometric inspired elements and electroformed enamel design. Xiang Ting is intrigued by the endless possibility of the triangle and the electroforming form from the two-dimensional form to the three-dimensional form to the wearer and the space created among the three. Xiang Ting will receive a first place award ribbon and cash award of $600. Congratulations, Xiang Ting. And now, the very exciting top award this year. Our Best in Show Award winner is Marie Wright, and Marie makes ceramics. Marie is from Pittsburgh, North Carolina. Marie makes crystalline glazed porcelain pottery. All of her work is hand-made on the potter's wheel, and she formulates all of her glazes herself. Each fabulous work catches the eye in vibrant emerald greens, delicate sky blue, to deeper shades of aqua and midnight blue. Marie will receive a Best in Show Award ribbon and a cash award of $1,000 and receives a free artist booth at CenterFest 2021. Congratulations, Marie.
Congratulations to all our CenterFest Merit Award winners. We encourage you to purchase work from these artists and from all the 57 visual artists featured on the website at centerfest2020.org. You can even sign up for curbside pickup of your art purchases from local artists while you're there. So thank you again to Durham Coca-Cola and the Herald Sun for sponsoring the awards this year. Durham Coca-Cola will be providing products, beverages of their choice for all of the artist award winners. And now back to the CenterFest broadcast.
I went to the capital city, the check on the nation and find out what happened to give me your tired and poor. Oh, but what did I see when I got to the steps of the White House? Frustration from decades being passed over, confused and denied. They're selling our bodies on every TV station. But heaven forbid I should choose what to do. $0.70 on the dollar, and watching a man run America into the ground. So I've got a question, mothers and sisters and daughters. Isn't it our turn for crying out loud? I'm on a mission. I'm gonna shatter the ceiling. Breaking on down, breaking on down. I'm on a mission, I'm gonna shatter the ceiling. Breaking on down, breaking on down.
The Durham Arts Council Arts Recovery Fund is helping artists, arts organizations, and arts businesses impacted by the COVID-19 pandemic. If you can, please donate to support arts recovery in Durham. Give so the arts can live.
We'll be right back. CenterFest. It's some beautiful jewelry and paintings out here, and I'm excited to come every year.
And the food, of course, is amazing. So come out and get you some good old food.
Amen.
Amen.
Welcome to CenterFest 2020, virtual arts festival presented by the Durham Arts Council. CenterFest 2020 virtual arts festival is sponsored by SciMed Solutions, NetFriends, Measurement Incorporated, Rivers, Adam Dickinson Realty Group, Durham Coca-Cola Bottling Company, The Herald Sun, Durham Magazine, WUNC North Carolina Public Radio, and Burge Records. Thank you to our sponsors, and thank you for watching. Enjoy the show.
Hi, everyone. I'm Heidi Carter, proud to serve as a county commissioner and also to serve as a member of the Durham Arts Council Board. I'm delighted to bring greetings and to welcome you to Virtual CenterFest 2020. Especially now during the COVID-19 pandemic, I truly value the arts. We need art to entertain us, inspire us, to lift our spirits, and to help us stay socially connected while physically distant. So I hope that you are enjoying CenterFest 2020 from the comfort of your own home and without even having to wear a mask. I know I certainly am.
Hi, I'm Sherry DeVries, the Executive Director of the Durham Arts Council. And from me and everyone here on the Durham Arts Council staff, we want to give a big thank you to Measurement Inc., our audiovisual sponsor, and to Tracy Talenko from Measurement Inc. for his amazing talents in helping us put this broadcast together. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
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 This is Boomerang. But you don't believe it, but I'm telling you. And although you think it's funny, I'm serious too. Can it be any other way? That's one of the things you try to say. And all the things just be the you want to reap but never pay. The lesson is fundamental, unnecessary too. Whatever you put out, I just come back to you. maybe it comes back to you.
Hey everybody, Dan Campbell, your contemporary artist in Cary, North Carolina. Thanks for coming by for a visit to the home gallery today. Here we go.
Picture paints a thousand words, then why can't I paint you? The words will never show the you I've come to know. If a face could launch a thousand ships, then where am I to go? There's no one home but you. Your old life is running dry. You come and pour yourself.
Folks, if you'd like to see more of my semi-abstract impressionistic style art, check me out at dancampbellart.com.
Arts Council is supportive, collaborative, community oriented, innovative, fund for all ages and abilities. Help the Durham Arts Council create a vibrant community through the arts. Please donate today.
Hey everybody, this is Bruce Pioff. I'm doing a song called Bigfoot in the Door about a baseball player named Tom Austin who was the first to break in with the St. Louis Cardinals back in 1954. Tom Austin swung a baseball bat, broke in with the Cardinals, first black man to do that. 1954, a Bigfoot in the door, Augustus Bush, the beer tycoon, made a big production, beer and silver spoons. Just one black man standing in the room. Give you two stand usuals, one Steve Belko, throwing country slaughter. If you let Austin go, big time Austin, Cardinals 54. I seen him yesterday down at the Woolworth store. Oh, big Tom Austin, he went to Dudley High, played ball for the Aggies, learned to catch high flies. Big Tom was a slugger, his Greensboro goodbye. San Diego Padres, 23 home runs and RBIs. Big Tom got 101. Headed for St. Louis, the segregation. Give you two Stan Musials, one Steve Belko, throwing country slaughter. If you let Austin go, Big Tom Austin, Cardinals 54. I seen him yesterday down at the Woolworth store. Tom Austin in a third-class coach the whole season long. Just like Willie Mays and Jackie Robinson, voices in the wind down in Mexico. Our big forgotten friend back in Greensboro, eating apple pie down at the Woolworth store. Give you two Stan Musials, one Steve Belko, throwing country slaughter. If you let Austin go, Big Tom Austin, Cardinals 54. I seen him yesterday down at the Woolworth store.
Hey there, this is Nicole Thompson, President CEO of Downtown Durham, Inc. Welcome to Downtown and the 46th CenterFest. We're so happy that this iconic downtown event is taking place this year in a way that keeps our community safe. The entire downtown community of businesses and residents are open and serving customers in a manner that is as safe as possible for our patrons and staff. While it's not yet time to gather in large groups, we appreciate the work that Durham Arts Council has done and all of the artists for being innovative in the way they are making this event happen. So welcome again virtually to CenterFest, and please come downtown and enjoy the beautiful art, sounds, and businesses.
Thank you.
the Durham Arts Council Arts Recovery Fund is helping artists, arts organizations, and arts businesses impacted by the COVID-19 pandemic. If you can, please donate to support arts recovery in Durham. Give so the arts can live.
Shepherd's wine, Eliza Jane. Oh, Eliza, Eliza Jane. Oh, Eliza, Eliza Jane. Seder plate, Eliza Jane. Oh, Elijah, Yahu Hanavi. Oh, Elijah, Yahu Hanavi. Oh, Elijah, Yahu Hanavi.
Thank you.
I'm Rick Grime, at Rick Grime Art on Instagram, rickgrimeart.com on the internet, and I hope we're going to do this in person next year. But big thanks to the Durham Arts Council for putting on this festival at all this year. Must have been a lot of work, so thank you. First up is this piece. I just finished it. This is kind of the direction I'm moving in, and I love the three-dimensionality of it and the simple color palette. And yeah, really excited about this. I'm gonna do a lot more of these. Moving on. I have some here, these three here on the left, inspired by subway maps and different cities that I've lived in, different cities that I've traveled in. Really enjoyed making those. Here we have pieces inspired by the fashion icon Iris Apfel. I love her style, her big jangly bracelets and earrings and stuff, and I just think she's amazing. And yeah, these paintings kind of came from imagining having drinks with her in her house or something. Up here, I want to draw attention to these two brown pieces. I just think of these as color vessels, like they're containers, these shapes. The shapes are containers that hold colors that I really like.
Thank you.
It's Cindy in the springtime. It's Cindy in the fall. If I can have my Cindy girl, I'll have my girl along. Just get along, 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 Cindy, get along, along.
The Durham Arts Council was formed in 1954, originally as Allied Arts. To this day, they remain a staple in the Durham community as a catalyst for cultural and artistic development in Durham by providing programs, services, and support for more than 120 arts organizations and more than 900 individual artists in our region. Additionally, the Durham Arts Council proudly supports more than 400,000 participants and visitors through classes, artist residencies, exhibits, festivals, grant programs, technical support, arts advocacy, and information services.